Hey guys, so history was recently made at this year's Oscars with the Asian representation of acting were recognized. And congratulations to Key and Michelle for taking home the Oscars, the awards for Everything Everywhere All at Once. It's just a freaking awesome achievement. And it got me thinking about the Latinos in Hollywood. And, you know, when you're in a different ethnicity, whether you're Latin, African American, even Asian, you know, the roles are a little bit different. You know, you have a typecast that you have to go through, unfortunately, you know, a junkie, a slave, a butler, a maid, a ganger, a gangbanger, a drug dealer, you know, some petty criminal. Unfortunately, those are the type of roles that minorities have gotten. And it got me thinking about, you know, all of the breakouts that we've achieved, you know, the breakout stars that we've achieved, like as far as from a Latin community, is you know, like Edward James Olmos and Andy Garcia, Antonio Banderas, and from a director standpoint, Alejandro González Iñárritu for, you know, being the first Latin to be back-to-back director, best director, in the Oscars. Not to mention Guillermo del Toro. So we've had some major successes. And that completely takes away from all of that typecasting and stereotype. But you know what? There have been some character actors that actually went through that grind and had to go through those roles. And I thought that it'd be great to finally recognize these guys. And, you know, they might not be Hollywood household names, but they're definitely Hollywood household faces, especially in the Latin community. And I'm going to start with Mr. Trinidad Silva. Trinidad Silva was born in Texas. He actually passed away in California. He was actually active for 11 years, from 77 to 88. He starred in The Jerk. He was in The Jerk, which grossed $100 million. He did that with Steve Martin. He was well known for Hill Street Blues, T.J. Hooker, Barney Miller. I would probably say that he's the most well known as Frog in Colors, and that performance in Colors was freaking awesome, man. That dude was so freaking cool. It was one of those, you know, kind of like roles where, you know, I know this guy. Like, I know this guy in real life, you know. He was in Jocks. He did some comedy. He did Jocks. If you've never seen Jocks, you got to check out Jocks. It's got Ogre in it. It's freaking hilarious. But anyway, sadly, he died in 88. In a car crash while he was filming UHF. And that movie with Weird Al Yankovic, he actually goes and he's doing all these crazy things with animals. It is freaking hilarious. But unfortunately, yeah, he did pass away while he was making this movie. And the crew and Weird Al actually dedicated UHF to Trinidad Silva. And at the end of the movie, I think. He was a talent, man. His life was sadly cut short, and I know that he would have taken that role of UHF to a whole other level, and two, I know that he would have been one of those guys, man, that would have taken it, you know, and been a lot better. You know, he would have gotten a lot better and worked with a lot of great people, and you know, I've always thought that he was gone too soon. Potential, you know, as far as talent goes, and I absolutely, you know, I love the guy. Right, what can I say? I love Trinidad Silva. So my first recognition goes to Mr. Trinidad Silva. And now let's move on to the next one, and that's going to be Mr. Danny De La Paz.